Get ready to match the stars. Robert Vaughn. Brett Summers. McLean Stevenson. Nancy Dussault. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hey. Hello there. Thank you. Brett, you're not applauding.
Well, it's because I'm so taken aback by your suit.
Oh, I see.
Or your jacket is the case.
Whatever.
I
was going to give your show a plug, the new Perry Mason.
And yes, and I've been replaced by Monty Markham because I'm crazy about him. He's the cutest thing that ever came down the pike.
Really?
Cuter than...
Be kind to Brett. Her parents wanted a girl.
You see the way it's going to be here. Well, I welcome all of our celebrated folk here. I thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Celebrate.
You're all celebrated there. You're really a dandy bunch of coconuts. And now let's say hello to the current champ. Here's Charlie Boldu. Hello, Charlie.
Hi, Gene. Thank you.
Charlie has won $6,200. See? I can tell you understand very well that money can only buy happiness. And Charlie's pretty happy about that. We're going to have a go at another over $5,000 right after we have a go at these messages. So stand by, Charlie. Now, here is our current champ, Charlie Boldu. He's done very well at the beginning of the Super Match here. He won the $500 in the audience match. That means he qualifies to play for 10 times that amount again, or $5,000. Now, to win the money, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match, Charlie. We ask you to choose one now.
Mrs. Ludden.
Oh, who?
Yeah. Oh, Mrs. Alan Ludden.
Oh,
Betty White, are you ready?
Yesterday.
All right, you get ready to write. You face me, if you would, please, sir. Here is the $5,000 question. Fill in this blank. Gas blank. Gas blank. Betty is finished. So, Charlie, we ask you to fill in the blank now for $5,000. Give us your response. How do you fill in that blank? Gas?
Station.
Gas station, he says. All right, Betty. For $5,000, may we see your answer, please?
Would you believe gas word? No, gas pipe. I don't want to
gas
play.
Gas pipe!
Oh, no.
All right, he's doing okay, though, Betty.
He has to match and everything.
Yeah, that's right. He's done up to $6,200 already, and he's still a current champ. He's going to meet another player. So let's meet that player right now. Here comes Charlene Jameson. Hello, Charlene. Charlene. That's a pretty name. You know Charlie. Charlene, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, please?
Yes, I've been married 9 years, and I'm a retired medical secretary, and I enjoy raising orchids and fuchsia. And I'm also a gourmet cook.
You have your own hothouse?
Right.
You do?
No, not
well, you
I
do
have
that
a hothouse
in the open out here
good.
In California, don't you?
Right.
Yeah. Well, you've got a very interesting life. You know how this game plays, so shall we start? All right, Charlene, you're the challenger. You'll make the selection if you would, please.
B, please.
This is for Charlene and for everybody over here. Yeah, celebrities do this.
Yeah.
Methuselah's wife said, my husband really is 900 years old. Just look at his blank. Methuselah's wife said that. She said, my husband really is
900 years old.
Just look at his blank. Put something on the card, and we'll let you stay on the show.
You still want me to drop by?
Robert and Brett are ready there. Oh, Richard is ready. McLean's ready. Okay, we're all set now. Now, Charlene, we call on you. excuse me, I'm a little twisted. There we are. Methuselah's wife said, my husband really is 900 years old. Just look at his...
whiskers.
Is his what?
His whiskers.
His whiskers. Oh, that's... she said whiskers. Mm. What did you say, Robert?
Pulled his show up out of the muck it's been in all week.
Yeah.
Clean answer.
Look at his birth certificate. Birth certificate. See how logical he is?
Right.
Are you logical, Brett? Whiskers is her answer.
No, I'm sorry. Look at his beard, which is the same as whiskers.
Beard, whiskers, how about that? That's a match. All right, here we go with the biblical student.
Well, I've chosen to take her right back down into the muck.
Oh.
No, I'm just joshing. I wanted to get my card out right. Is it right? I said
right.
Face.
Yes. Face. Look at his face.
To you too, fella.
All right, Nancy.
just look at his wrinkles.
Wrinkles.
He's got a lot of them.
Yeah.
I'd like to
well,
talk
Methuselah.
About
yeah, 900 is a long time.
I'd like to use it.
All right, what about it, Richard?
He had so many wrinkles when he passed away, they had to screw him into the ground. Wrinkles.
Wrinkles. So we got two wrinkles in a row there.
Well, thank you. We're happy
Let's
with it.
Let's see. Whiskers is her answer. Betty, what's yours?
Look at his body, and I don't want to discuss it.
Okay. All right. Charlie. That's one for Charlene. And now let's see how the champ Charlie Boldu do with this.
Did you say doo-doo? That's what my children say, doo-doo.
Yeah, I don't know.
They say I have to go doo-doo.
No, I'm not.
Well, actually, they don't say that anymore
because
they've gotten older.
You're ruffling him. Hit it.
Either be quiet or get your own show. Robert wrote this poem to his wife.
Uh-huh.
There's blue in the sky and red in the flag. I can't stand your mother. She's really a blank. Yes, one more time. Did you hear that, Charlie?
Yes, I did, Gene.
Every deathless word of it, did you?
Fantastic poetry.
There's blue in the sky and red in the flag. I can't stand your mother. She's really a... They're all ready, so say it, Charlie. A what?
Nag.
A nag, he says. Nag is his answer, Robert.
No, she's a queen mother and therefore a drag.
She's a drag, I see.
No.
He gets more intellectual with every
you know,
answer,
doesn't
he?
He's getting worse.
He's really dumb. A good actor, but boy, is he dumb.
Now, Brett, would you save the day, please, before we get to fisticuffs?
I frankly think that Robert is as smart as a whip. Drag.
Drag. See?
Yeah.
All right, let's
well,
see what little gem you got
you.
Here.
I wish I could learn to get my cards out straight.
Nag is the answer.
Nag.
Nag is the answer. There's a match. Now, Charlie Boldu applauds you. Now, Nancy, what are you going to do?
McLean has to be worked with. She really is a hag.
Hag. All right.
It's so depressing, that sound.
Dawson.
Hit it.
Through life's lanes we wander. Our hopes are never dim. Though memories we may squander, I shall remember her. I wrote hag.
Nag was his answer. It's still 1-1, and let's see if you break the tie.
Me too. There's blue in the sea and red in the flag. I can't stand your mother. She's really a witch. A bag.
A bag. So we had nags and bags and heads and all that.
We won.
And at the end of round one, the score is tied 1-1. We'll get to round two right after we get to this for you. Another ride. Okay, we finished round one. The score is tied 1-1, and we'll go to round two and ask the challenger to make a selection.
Yes, B, please.
All right, Charlene wants B. Last time out, she matched Brett, so you will be the only one who will
we
not
have
participate.
An important announcement to make.
They're not supposed to do
what,
that.
What is going
on? I get so lonely.
Oh, well, I'll
time just
right
flies
here,
away.
Close to you while I'm reading this one. On the jungle safari, after the giant man-eating plant ate Marsh's husband, it blanked. Are you listening, McLean?
I didn't know we were on. I was going to go like that.
McLean.
I'm sorry. I really didn't. Now read the question.
We're
again.
On, McClane.
Okay, I'm ready.
We've got to get Loretta Swit here. I can't keep my eye on both of them every minute.
I mean, everybody's got their
on the jungle safari. On the jungle safari, yes. After the giant man-eating plant ate Marsha's husband, it blanked.
Sure.
Sure. Well, then write it down, if you believe it. Okay. Brett is the only one who does not write because she
met
Charlene last time around.
Sorry.
Now we're all set, so Charlene will get your response. The giant man-eating plant ate Marsha's husband. It blanked.
Burped or belched.
Burped or belched, she says. Burped or belched, she says. Robert Vaughn, what do you
say? Back into the muck.
Into the muck?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's a big burp. Or a big belt, is it not?
It says it poked.
Phew.
No, it says it now.
But she's in bad taste.
Read.
A big belt.
Read your answer.
I don't have
right.
to.
She doesn't
and no talking. No talking.
It's my turn.
It's his turn.
Okay. Now get the guys in the wash and wear suits and the hush puppies together, because this is going to be another me. I said barfed. I don't want to hear a bzzz.
They said it's a lot better than you.
No, listen. But a barf and a belch, where I come from, are approximately the same. One's a little messier than the other, of course.
Okay. Well, they say it doesn't match. We'll have to call on Nancy and see what she's got here.
Oh,
the answer is burped from Charlene.
I said threw up. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Is that offensive?
Richard, what do you say?
I said burp.
Burp. There's another match for you, Charlene. And Betty White.
How do you get out of this outfit? I never thought this would be a classy answer, but burped it is.
It is. Okay, so you're up to three with that one.
Not a classy answer.
Now, Charlie,
you know Marsha's husband.
You must match two celebrities to stay in the game. Three, however, will win another game for you. Here we go. Everyone plays except McClane, because he matched Charlie last time.
I mean, it wasn't anything I said. It's just...
No, it's all right.
Actually, yes.
Here we go. And, okay, McClane's the only one. This light is on for some strange reason.
Well, his card's in it. I told you he was dumb.
You answered the question before I asked it, huh?
I'm going to keep using that one over and over.
All right.
Did you read his book, Only the Victims? It's incredible. It's in a magnificent book. How can he be so dumb?
Somebody else wrote the book.
Very, very, very intellectual fellow. Here we go. The cabbie said, I picked up Zsa Zsa right after her last wedding, and she left her blank in my back seat.
Oh, have I got an answer for that? But I wouldn't.
The cabbie said, I picked up Zsa Zsa right after her last wedding, and she left her blank in my back seat. Please write something if you would.
Oh, dear.
Print is what I mean to say. Thinking about that one, Charlie? Hold on. Wait until we get all the answers in, and we will call on you. Everybody's ready, so we'll call on our champion and get a response from him. I picked up Zsa Zsa right after her last wedding, and she left her blank in my back seat.
I don't know Zsa Zsa, but I know a girl. A bra.
Zsa Zsa left her bra in the back seat.
He's as dumb as Robert Vaughn.
2-3 three to win.
Let's see what happens here now. You don't have to leave the back seat. You can wait until you get there, right?
Right. I don't know. Robert, what do you say?
I said a bouquet.
A bouquet of flowers.
A little eloquent.
Classy answer. Right. Brett?
Well, I tried to give a little class to the show, too.
Yeah.
I said
failing
innocence.
Miserably, Brett.
She left her innocence. Okay, we come down here to Nancy.
What is it?
Would you show and tell, please?
Oh, I said bouquet also.
Bouquet. Now, you must match Richard and Betty to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Go, Richard.
I happen to know that she left her wash and wear wedding gown in the back.
Oh, our champion is Charlene. Congratulations. Will you come down, please? Okay. All right, you've got $100, and we congratulate you, and we've got to have a word or two here with Charlie Boldu. You're not unhappy to go.
Not at all.
You're ready to spend that money, aren't you? How
yes,
much have you got, Charlie?
$6,200.
Good for you. Charlie Boldu. Thank you, Charlie. Come on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right.
Now, you young lady, we'll get to you right after we get to this, so you stick around. Charlene Jameson here has just won her first game. She's got $100 to her credit. She's happy about that. Are you happy about
Very
that?
Very happy.
Good. Would you like to go on with the rest of it?
Very.
Yeah, we'd like to go on with the rest of it, too.
Tape is rolling.
She's going to have a go. And over $5,000 here in the Super Match. And this is the way it goes. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. P.T. Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you, Charlene, if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. You may get a little help from three celebrities, so let's start choosing those one at a time.
Okay, Betty.
How do you do that, Betty?
P.T. Barnum.
P.T. Barnum is what she said. There's one response.
Richard.
P.T.A. Who does that? Tape is rolling.
Nancy.
P.T. Boat?
P.T. Boat.
Is that a boat? Is that a boat?
P.T. Boat. Right. So you got P.T. Barnum, P.T.A., and P.T. Boat. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own, Charlene. What would you like to do?
P.T.A.
P.T.A. is the answer. You're letting the audience influence you, aren't you?
No, that was my first impression.
It was? Yeah. Okay. If you trust your first impression here, usually it does pretty well. We've all got our fingers crossed for you. We're looking for the PTA. Where are you, PTA? Are you under the $100 response? No, you are not. The PT boat is under there.
Well, that's not terrible. You know
no, that's
mean?
Very good.
Give
I would have been a winner if you'd chosen that. Okay, still looking for the PTA. Here is a $250 response. P.T. Barnum is up there. That's the one Betty gave you. Looks like you're getting close. That may be a good omen. Third and last chance, Charlene, for the PTA. Here is the $500 response.
Yay!
PTA! Very good. That's enough. That's enough.
Come on.
No, come on. It's only $500.
How about a little something for the dummies up here?
Oh, yeah. You got it, McLean.
I got it.
That's okay. What dummies get.
Now, here we go on. You've got the $500, and I know you're excited about that because it really is a lot of money. That puts you up to $600.
Yay.
More important than that, you're going to have a go at 10 times that amount now or $5,000. So collect. You've got to match one of those people over there. On a head-to-head basis, and it has to be an exact match. Please choose one now.
Richard.
She chooses you, Richard. You get ready to write, sir. And Charlene will face me, and I'll get the $5,000 question. Here it is. Blank bonnet. Or blank bonnet. I'll give you both accents. Richard is ready. Now, Charlene, you give us your response. How do you fill in the blank? Blank bonnet.
Sunbonnet.
Sunbonnet is what she says, and some people in the audience think it's good, and some think it's not so good. But it's up to Richard to show us his $5,000 answer now, please.
Blue bonnet.
Blue bonnet. So we had a sunbonnet and blue bonnet. Actually, two very good answers. Mm-hmm. Listen, Charlene, you're still the champ. You've got the $600. You're going to meet another player, so let's do that right now. Here comes Candy Jones.
Candy Jones. Where are you, Candy? Hello there. All right, would you step back up? Candy, you know Charlene? How are you, Candy?
I'm fine.
Ready to have a go here?
Sure.
Tell us a little bit about yourself first, if you please.
Well, I'm an airline hostess.
Yeah.
I've been flying for about 5 years, and I also help teach an airline stewardess training program at Santa Ana College in Santa Ana.
Well, that sounds like you have a very interesting life.
I do.
Ladies, we'll get back to you in a second or two and chat a little bit more, but right now we've got to pass along this message to you. We don't have time to start this game, and we'll look forward to seeing you, Candy, and you, Charlene, next time we all get together. Now, whether you know a little bit about you, you've got your $600, and you're going to challenge Charlene, and we'll see how that works out. I'd like to say goodbye to each one of you individually, to Robert Vaughn, and we all enjoy seeing Robert Vaughn and the Protectors, don't we? You enjoy doing that show?
Yes, I do.
You do that out here, do you?
No, I do that in the other part of the world, called Europe.
Yes, it's very interesting.
Yes, it is.
And that lady, she's on the new Perry Mason thing all the time.
That's true.
And he's one of the world's funniest men in one of the world's funniest shows.
I wouldn't say that.
Yes, he is. He's in a show called MASH. You know that show? This lady has just done two marvelous specials that you're going to be seeing sometime soon, right?
In December.
Well, I don't even know. I don't even know when that is.
I don't either.
And
I'm dating a sailor in San Pedro. I'm just sending a message.
So sick, Dickie.
And what are you up to?
A Gumby special coming
another
up.
Another Mary Tyler Moore show.
Another Mary Tyler Moore show.
The Happy Home Hooker.
Terrific. Happy Home
Maker.
Okay. Listen.
Were you drinking?
You've all been delightfully daffy, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Gene Rayburn here saying so long. The Match Game 73. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Christmas catalog. The charm and beauty of a Tiffany table lamp. It's yesterday's lighting today. A fine item from the Montgomery Ward catalog. And Clairol's four-way lighted mirror, so you can make up in the lights you'll be seen in. Clairol's four-way lighted mirror and Clairol's three-way hair setter gives your curl more choices. Waterless, conditioned, mist, or regular sets. Clairol's three-way hair setter. And from Weinbrenner Shoe Company of Merrill, Wisconsin, two pairs of famous wooden stream hunting and hiking boots for leisure time in the great outdoors from Weinbrenner. And Snowy Bleach, the exclusive blended formula with extra washes per box, safe for whites and colors. Snowy Bleach. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.